Hello and welcome to the 44th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to easily color enhance your video footage in After Effects. Now, working with video, you will always want to make sure it looks the best it can. Sometimes, when we bring video into After Effects, it can look a little flat. Now, After Effects is really good at color grading and adding color enhancements to video footage. In this video, we are going to look back over the video presentation we have been working on up until this point. We are going to look at some of the video we have placed into the video presentation so far and use some of the helpful effects and presets in After Effects to enhance the color and quality. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate just how easy this can be done in After Effects. So in this video, we are going to be covering the following topics: using the Auto Contrast preset, using the Edit Levels preset, and using the Edit Curves preset. So let's get into it. So here I am where we left off in the previous episode where we completed these five sections. Up until this point on the project, we have mainly been focusing on the structure of the presentation and getting all the animated sequences right. Now before we start working on the last section to finish, I want to reflect back on what we have done so far. So let's take a look. Now if you're watching for the first time and wish to follow along, you can find this document in the project folder, which you can download. Link is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. With the project folder open, click into folder S3, create a project, then click into folder 44, color enhancing footage, and open the color enhancing document. Now, if you're continuing on from the last episode, make sure you have your document open and ready. So with our document open, let's proceed. So right now I have the main comp open and we can see we have our six sections. If I click and drag the time indicator right back to the start and slowly scrub along the timeline, here we can see our intro sequence, section 1, which plays out and leads nicely into section 2. We have section 2 with the video and type transitions, and this leads into section 3, the aquarium. Now looking at some of the video in this sequence, it's nice, but it does look a little flat in parts. So what I want to do here is quickly enhance the video. So to do this, I'll double click into the aquarium composition. Now if we look towards the bottom of the timeline panel, we can see the video layers we placed into the comp in a previous video. So I'll click and drag my time indicator towards the start of the comp so I can see the first video in my composition panel above. So the first video is the underwater scene, and what I want to do is make the blacks a little darker to punch out the blues. So I'll start by selecting the video layer in the timeline panel. Next, I'll come over to the right-hand side of the interface and click on the Effects and Presets panel. This will reveal all the effects and presets we can use. Now, if for whatever reason you cannot see the Effects and Presets panel, you can come up to Window, scroll down and click Effect and Presets. So in this panel, I will come and toggle down the Color Correct category. And at the top, you will see three really useful presets: Auto Color, Auto Contrast, and Auto Levels. Now, we can use these to apply simple and immediate effects to our video. On this occasion, I'm going to use the Auto Contrast. So with my video selected in the timeline panel, I'll click and drag the Auto Contrast preset across and out of the Effects and Presets panel and onto my selected video layer. Upon release, we will see a subtle change to the video as the Auto Contrast is applied. Now, upon release, we should now also see the effects controls appear where the project panel is on the left. In the effects controls, we can see that as well as the linear wipe transition effect we applied earlier, we now have an auto contrast effect. Now if I come and click the FX icon, we can turn the effect on and off and see a before and after. So when you apply an auto contrast, it will apply contrast to your video. But if you want to tweak this further, you can come up to the effect controls panel and tweak the settings. So here I'll come down and drag the black clip over to 5%. And if I click the FX button, we can toggle it on and off and see the before and after effect. Now, should you tweak the effect and feel you have overdone it or it's not to your liking, we can come to the top of the auto contrast settings and simply click the reset button. That will put the settings back to what they were at the start, but right now I'm pretty happy with this, so I'll just leave it for now and move on. So I'll drag my time indicator further right along the timeline to see my next video. So again, I want to boost the contrast here to make the blacks darker to make the colors pop. So I'll select the video layer, come over to the Effects and Presets panel, and again drag the Auto Contrast preset out and drop it onto my selected video layer. Upon release, I can see that has had the effect I want. In the Effects and Controls panel to the left, if I click the FX button, we can see the before and after effect. So moving on, I'll drag my time indicator further along the timeline to see my next video. Again, I want to boost the contrast here to make the blacks darker and make the colors pop. So I'll select the video layer, come over to the Effects and Presets panel, and again drag the Auto Contrast preset out and drop it onto the selected video layer. Upon release, I can see that has had the effect I want. And again, in the Effects and Controls panel to the left, if I click the Effects button, we can see the before and after effect. So for this aquarium sequence, I'm going to apply the Auto Contrast to each video layer. So moving on, I'll drag my time indicator further right to my next video. Again, I want to boost the contrast, so I'll select the video layer, come over to the Effects and Presets panel, and drag the Auto Contrast preset onto my selected video layer. Next, I'll drag my time indicator further right to see my last video in the sequence. I'll select the video layer, come over to the Effects and Presets panel, and drag the Auto Contrast preset out and onto the selected video layer. Nice! So, just like that, I subtly enhanced the contrast of each video clip in this sequence. Overall, this makes the underwater video look more rich and vibrant in the background. So once I'm happy, I can click back into the main comp tab in the top left of my timeline panel, and I'm back to my main comp. So I'll drag the time indicator over the next section, the Shoreditch section, and I can see that the videos and images here are looking fine. So I'm not going to apply any color effects to these. Now if I drag over to the Camden section, I can see that there are some clips in here that could do with a little enhancing. So I'll double click into the Camden composition and it will open up in its own tab. If we look towards the bottom of the timeline panel, we can again see the video layers we placed into the comp in a previous video. So I'll click and drag my time indicator towards the start of the comp so I can see the first video in my composition panel above. So what I want to do here is again make the blacks a little darker to punch out the colors. So I'll start by selecting the video layer in the timeline panel, and I'll come back over to the Effects and Presets panel. And this time, instead of using one of the autocorrect presets, I'm going to come down the panel about 3/3 of the way and select Levels. This time, I'm going to click and drag Levels out from the Effects and Presets panel and drop it onto the video layer. Now, upon release, nothing will happen, because what we have to do now is come into the Effects controls over on the left and tweak the settings. So here, I'm going to come and focus on the Input Black. So I'll come and drag this in a little to around 15. Next, I'll come and tweak the gamma and push this up a little to around 1.3. And if I come and click the Effects button for the Levels effect, we can see the before and after effect. So using the Levels has allowed me to manually tweak the Input Black and gamma to enhance the video clip. So I'll continue to drag my time indicator over the remaining video clips, and these are looking okay. But when I get to the fourth clip here, we can see it looks a little flat. So I'll start by selecting the video layer, and I'll come back over to the Effects and Presets panel. And this time, instead of using the Levels preset, I'm going to come and select Curves. This time, I'm going to click and drag Curves out from the Effects and Presets panel and drop it onto my video layer. Now, upon release, nothing will happen, because we will have to now come into the Effects and Controls over on the left and tweak the settings. Now, for any of you that are familiar with using curves in Photoshop, you will understand how it works here. So over in the Effects and Controls panel, we will see our grid and the curve. Now I'm going to drop 3 points on the curve here, one in the middle, one towards the bottom left, and one towards the top right. I'll start by clicking and dragging the far right point up, and I'll drag down the far left point a little, and drag the center point up a little. By doing that, we have boosted the colors and made the blacks deeper. This has created a more dynamic effect. Now if I come and click the FX button for curves, we can see the before and after effect. So using the curves has allowed me to create a more dynamic effect to the video. Now with curves applied, you can come into the effects controls and change the channel. For example, I'll click the drop down and change the tab to blue. I'll click to drop down 3 points like I did a second ago, one in the middle, one towards the bottom left, and one towards the top right. Now, if I start to click and drag these, we can change the channel of specific colors and change the color effect of the video. For now though, I only want to boost the blacks, so I'll hit the reset button at the top of the setting. I'll make sure the tab is set back to RGB and I'll click my 3 points. One in the middle, one towards the bottom left, and one towards the top right. And I'll click and drag the left one down a little, the far right up, and the center one up just a little, again to enhance the video. Perfect. So looking at the next video, this is looking okay. So that finishes the Camden section. So now I can click back into the main comp by clicking on the top left tab. And now I am back to my main comp. So I'll click just after marker 7 and press N to clip the end of the workspace. I'll drag my time indicator back to the start of the comp, and I'll click on the resolution factor at the bottom of the composition panel and set this to half. Now, on this occasion, I don't want to hear the music, so I'm going to come down and click on the second icon on the audio layer to toggle this off. For now, this will mute the audio layer, but if you are following along, I recommend you leave this on. So with my time indicator at the start, I'll press spacebar to activate preview. So now I can preview the entire video presentation in real time. As it previews, I can see my intro, which leads into the video sections. Now, if you're following along, you should also hear the music and see how the sections cut nicely to the music. Also, we can now see the enhancements we have just made to some of the video clips in the aquarium section and the Camden section. So this is all looking good. So that completes the 6 sections. We are now ready to move on to the last and final section in this video presentation. Now at this point, if you are following along with your own document, I would recommend you save so we can continue on in the next episode. So what we are going to do next is build the last section of our video presentation. This is going to be similar to the intro section where we used some simple 2D graphics. In the next video, we are going to create a simple 2D scene consisting of graphics and type, where later I'll be showing you how to animate them. So see you in the next video.